Okay, we will see today transfer requirement. Okay, I am Venkat Reddy, and we will see today the important concept of warehouse management, that is transfer requirement. So we'll see some important aspects of transfer requirement today. Like the first point is how to create the number ranges of transfer requirement, and creation of transfer requirement manually. And automatic creation of transfer requirement. Okay, and also we can see some important T codes of transfer requirement. And how to convert TR to TO. And we can also see deleting of TR. Okay, so first you will see the how to create number ranges for transfer requirement. Logistic execution, warehouse management, master data, define number ranges. So this is the place where we create number ranges for most of the requirements. Okay, that is for a quant or for a posting change. Posting change will come in the transfer postings, and group will come for a multiple picking process, and transfer requirement, transfer order, quant are normal things. And this is for storage unit number. We have a SU management will be used over there, SU storage unit management. Okay, for transfer requirement you create and you take any warehouse number that you want to create. For example, 015, click intervals. Okay, so this is the number range already maintained, but our warehouse number is 888. Click interval. Okay, see, whenever we copy the warehouse to an another warehouse, automatically the number range will get copied, and the current TR number is 30. Almost we have used some 29, and the current number is at right now at 30. Go back and click number ranges. So the number ranges whatever we create over there, click position button, warehouse number, and you have to give that number range here, that is 01. Okay, go back. And if you want to create any another number range, means click here intervals, go back. So plus interval, you can create the number ranges if you want any new number range. Okay, but we already have this number range so that you can leave it. And this is the way we create the number ranges for a transfer requirement. So how to create a transfer requirement manually? Okay, the next one is how to create a transfer requirement manually. Okay, so let me show you how to create a transfer requirement manually. Go to Easy Access, Logistics, Logistic Execution, In-house Internal Warehouse Process, transfer requirement create, and the T code is LB01. Okay, LB01 is the T code. You put your warehouse number and your movement type 201 or anything. Enter a requirement number for movement type. Okay. So this requirement number is for just for tracking purpose, nothing on that. So plant 1000, material of, okay, you take AAA only, so TR quantity. Okay, save this. So this is the way we have to create a manual TR number. Okay, and automatic creation of transfer requirement. So we have to go to the configuration now, /n spro, SAP reference IMG, logistics execution, warehouse management, go to interfaces, inventory management, define movement types. Click LEWM interface to inventory management. Okay, you put your warehouse number and your reference movement type number. Enter. So this tick mark here, if X is there, then you will get the transfer requirement created. Okay. So this B is for the purchase order process. So this controls your transfer requirement is created or not created based on this one only. Save it. And now, so important T codes of TR. So first we will see the conversion of TR to TO. LT04. Okay, see here. We have created TR before. So that TR is there now. I am creating now TO. Okay. And now you can confirm the transfer order by saving. Okay. So you will discuss more in the future classes about TR and TO. And now some important T codes of okay, let me create a TR and we'll show you how to deleting of TR. So we have just seen converting of TR into TO. Now we will see the deleting of TR. Go to LB01, your movement type 201, enter any number here is fine, that is just a reference number. Okay, save it. But 32, right? Go to LB02. Okay. Do you want to delete the transfer requirement? Yes. Transfer requirement deleted. Okay. See here. Transfer requirement does not exist. Okay. Now we'll see some important T codes of TR. Very, very important. See here. LB01 is for manual creation of TR. LB02 is for change transfer requirement. And during the change also, actually it is change or delete. LB03 is for display. And LB04 is not there. So we have LB10 is for display transfer requirement per storage type. So if you go, sorry, 001. So no data available because all transfer requirements are completed or moved into transfer order. Okay. If you go to LB11, display transfer requirement for list of material. So it will give you the all the transfer requirements which are available for the TR. Okay, by material. So these are the some important things of the TR. Okay. So we will also see the SAP reference IMG slash N. If you go to display here, okay, display transfer requirement. Okay, this transfer requirement we already deleted. Okay, this transfer requirement does not exist. Let me create a transfer requirement and we'll go to the display. LV01 movement type 201. So you can give the transfer priority also here. Okay, first you give the material and the quantity. Suppose for example if it is any special stock, then you have to give a special stock indicator here. Okay, and if we have any batch number and the plant is not required here. Plant will pick automatically based on the warehouse. Okay, now go to LB02. Okay, I want to show you there is a deletion flag indicated here. So instead of deleting transfer requirement from here, you can even set the deletion flag indicator here. Okay, if you set up the deletion flag indicator, it will get deleted automatically. List of changes. Okay. So we'll move back to the easy access. Okay, for material document. So if you want to see the material document, 2014, warehouse number, AAA, and this is a mandatory field here. So if you enter the correct material document number, then you will get to able to see this by requirement. See, by requirement number. See, if you remember, I was giving some requirement number. If you can see here, remember. So that requirement number will come to here. For example, LV01 requirement number 11. 201. So this and go to easy access. Okay, can you see here? So the requirement number is used to track your transfer requirements. So in this way, transfer requirement tracking transfer requirement number is very important. Okay, go back. So we have one more simple topic slash n spro. warehouse management, master data, strategies, okay, generate interim storage bins. Okay, Chule. Okay, it already exists, but if it don't exist, then we have to create. Interim storage bins are important. For an example, see, every time let me take in another. Okay, if it is already exist, if it is not existing, then it will ask you to create the bins. So it is only important when you want. See, normally the purchase order will get created as a bin number. Okay, the purchase order will be converted as a bin number in interim storage type. Okay, in interim storage type, the purchase order number will be created as a bin number. But sometimes when we don't have the interim storage type, okay, when we don't have the interim storage type, for example, we have generate interim storage bins is used normally in warehouse in WM process. PO number will be created as interim storage bin. But sometimes whenever you are issuing the stock, 201K. So in this scenario, we don't have PO number here, right? PO number is missing. For this purpose only, we have generate interim storage bins. So wherever we don't have the storage bins, wherever we don't have the purchase order as a interim storage bin, then we have to create interim storage bins, so that interim storage bins will be useful whenever we do the transactions which is not relevant to the purchase order process. Wherever the purchase order is not there, for an example, goods issued to cost center, we don't have any purchase order here. For an example, initial entry of the stock balances, GR without purchase order number. So in these cases, we don't have any interim storage bin. Okay, let me go to MyGo screen for to see this example. MyGo. Okay. Goods receipt other. So without PO number here, without charge. Initial entry of stock balances. Storage location 3402. Okay, now you check it. And post. Okay, So here, if you go to the display, WM tab, you see from where this bin came, because this bin was created as part of the intent storage bin. So if you try to notice it, it is AUFNAHME. See here, the same bin was created as part of intent storage bin in your configuration, so that you are able to see this, that one, okay, / n spro reference img logistic execution warehouse management interfaces inventory management generate internal storage. See here AUF. So this bin number exists over there because there is no PO number. If there is a PO number there, automatically we will get the PO number there. Because of that, we get this one. That is the reason why interim storage bins are very, very important. Okay. So we'll see our next topic, next video. We'll see the importance of the transfer order, and then we'll go to the next topic.